In this video, we'll go over advanced pivot table tips and tricks, and to make it more realistic, we'll be using this data set and pretend we're working as business analysts at Nike with our manager asking us a set of questions. And these are gonna get progressively harder as we move along, so stick around until the end. First up, looking at the data set, which you can download in the description below, you can see over here that we've got Nike's retail partners, and so here's all their names alongside their region, the product that they're currently selling, and their financials over here to the side. If you want to see how long this data set's for, just press Control down arrow, and you'll see it's got about 4,000 rows, Control up arrow to get back up. And our manager, who's not very good on Excel, is asking us to find out what our sales by region look like. For this, we're simply going to go inside the database, go to Insert, Pivot Table, and we're okay with this range, hit okay there, and that's gonna open up a new sheet for us. So within this sheet, we said we wanted the region, so we'll put that as a row over here. And our manager also said that he wanted the total sales, so let's say we put that over here to the side. So now we've got the sales by region. Let's go ahead and reformat this a bit. So right click, number format, and say we put it in dollar signs, just so it's a bit easier to see with a few commas in there. So accounting, let's say we go for zero decimal places and hit okay. So we show our manager these findings, but he's not entirely happy as he says the numbers are very big and so they're hard to read. And instead he wants them as a proportion, so a percentage essentially out of the total. So let's go ahead and try that on the pivot table. So we'll go back to the pivot table fields, go to total sales again, and we'll drag that one inside of values again. So you'll see that you have a total sales 2. And so that's gonna be this one over here, which we wanna change to a percentage. So we'll go to right click there, go to show values as, and from here we're gonna go as a percentage of grand total. And now you can see that you've got all of the different proportions. And if you drag all of them across, that should give you 100, as you can see down over here. And so now it's very, very easy to tell that the West seems to be the highest seller, followed by the Northeast. So we show him these proportions as well, but he's still not entirely happy. And we'd actually like to see date ranges. As of now, we just have the total, so within that whole date range, but instead he'd like to be able to filter through different dates, like what happened in a specific quarter or in a specific month. Now to do so, luckily it's got an easy fix. We're simply gonna go under over here under pivot table fields, and under the invoice date, which is gonna show us all of the dates that we have, we're just gonna right click inside it and go to add as timeline. And so over here you'll find this timeline. Let me go ahead and reformat it. Using this timeline, our manager is going to be able to change all his date ranges, so you can go ahead and change them like so, as you can see. Or even better, you can also go through this drop down, and so here it says by months, you can filter that by quarter. So suppose we want only the first 2 quarters, and everything is going to change dynamically with it as well. And if you're finding this pivot tables video slightly too complex for you, you can check out this other one somewhere up here, which goes over more of the basic functions. Now going back to the data set, and suppose our manager wants to find out what are the top 10 states in terms of sales. So for this, we'll go ahead and create another pivot table. So we'll go under insert again, pivot table, hit okay there, and that should generate it for us. And so we mentioned we want the state, so we'll put the state as the row over here, and we're gonna put the total sales over as the values. But the problem is now we have about 50 different states here, which is a bit too much for us as we really only want the top 10 of those. Now for this, you're gonna go under this dropdown for row labels, and inside it, under value filters, you're gonna be able to find the top 10, which is what we're looking for. If you click inside it, you'll have a ton of different options, not just the top 10, but the bottom. Maybe it's not 10, maybe it's the top 15 you want. In our case, we're fine with this, so we'll hit okay there. That's exactly what we get. If we count all of these, we have exactly 10 in here. But the problem is that they're not in order right now. They're actually in a random order, so we're just gonna have to sort these. We can go ahead and right click. Then let's say we go for sort. We're gonna sort largest to smallest. And let's also change this to accounting format. So we'll go right click, number format, and then in here we're gonna go to accounting, no decimal places, and hit okay. And now you can see that New York and California seem to be the top sellers for us. And if you didn't know some of these tricks and you wanna learn more, you can consider taking our Excel for Business and Finance course, where we teach everything we know about Excel, specifically for people either looking to break into a business or a finance role, or those in it trying to level up their Excel game. Unlike most theoretical courses, we tried to make this one as practical as possible. So aside from the typical lessons on formatting, formulas, charts, and other theory, we have case studies that, much like this video, replicate the type of work you might be assigned in your day-to-day, ranging from financial modeling to cleaning a dataset and presenting some visual insights. We also have two real-life Excel interview tests to help you in the recruitment process. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can go to the link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Given the high inflation we're currently experiencing, suppose our manager wants to find out how many units sold we have at certain price ranges. So at the $50 mark, what about at the $100 mark? And is there some kind of improvement we can make? To analyze that, we'll simply go back to the dataset. We'll go to insert again, pivot table, hit okay there. And from here, what we're gonna wanna have is the price per unit. Let's say we put that under the rows. And we're also gonna put the units sold under the values. So that's actually the quantity here. But you can see that we have a ton of different labels, really way too many to be able to interpret this. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna group them into categories. So we'll just click on any of these, go to right click, and we're gonna go to group. Now to make this a bit more realistic and probably better for us to understand, let's say we start at zero and we're gonna end it at something like 120. And we want the increments at something like every $20. So that's gonna be the different groups. Hit okay there. Now you can see that we've got a ton of different labels. So from 0 to 20, from 20 to 40, etc. So it's a lot easier for us to read. From here, we can create some kind of a chart, say. We can go to pivot table analyze for that. Then we're gonna go to pivot chart, hit okay there. And now you can see that it's a lot more clear that currently under the 40 to 60 range is where the majority of our sales are. And because we're great employees and we wanna help out our manager, it'd also be useful to find out with different products if this is gonna change at all. So suppose we're selling women's apparel, is that gonna be any different to men's apparel? Now to find out about that, let's go under the product, which is gonna be under the pivot chart fields. We'll right click on it. From here, you're gonna go to add a slicer. And so we're gonna put this slicer for it on the side. Now you can clearly see if I select men's apparel, this is kind of where the trend's at. So it's primarily on the 40 to 60 range. Whilst if I go to women's apparel, then all of a sudden that kind of changes quite a bit, where the 60 to 80 range is a bit better. So perhaps for Nike, it'd be better to prioritize the 60 to 90 range, as it's reasonable to assume that they have better margins there. To work on the formatting of this chart a bit, one thing you can do is remove these boxes, which really we don't need right now, just by going to pivot chart analyze and deselecting that fields button. That's gonna remove them for you. Same thing with the legend, we don't really need it. And for the products, you'll notice that you can only select one now. If you want to select more than one, you can click over here to this tick sign, and that's going to allow you to select multiple. Similarly, if you want to select all of them, just go to the unfilter over here. That's going to do it for you. Now, let's say our regional sales managers are all asking for a sales report to see how they're performing. Now, to do so, we'll go back to the data set at the start. We'll go to insert again, pivot table, and hit OK there. To make this useful for them, let's say we put the total sales as the values, and we're also gonna put the operating profit so they can see what that's like. And then over on the rows, we're gonna want the different dates. So we're just gonna go to the invoice date, and now we're gonna get the month. So let's remove the invoice date from there, and we're just gonna keep the month like so. But the problem here is that we still haven't accounted for the different regions. Now to do so, we'll go under the region and we're gonna filter this instead. So up top over here where you can see, you're just gonna go to a drop down and you can select a specific region that you want. Now from there, here's gonna be the cool part where you can duplicate this action for all the different regions that we have. So you'll go under the options drop down under pivot table analyze, click on that, and inside here, you're gonna go to show report filter pages. Click on that once, we want that by region, hit okay there. And now it's gonna create all of these different tabs for each region. So if you go control page down, you can see that it's got the Northeast, the South, Southeast, West, etc. And so that's basically the idea here, where you've been able to filter everything all in once. And so suppose you have maybe 50 different states that you need to send this to, you can do this all in one go. For more on pivot tables, check out this link over here to create an interactive budget dashboard using pivot tables, or this other link over here to learn about our Excel courses. Hit that like and that subscribe button if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.